Hi everyone, my name is Sagar Gohil and I'm an engineer with Azure Identity Chat team. Today I'm going to show you how IT admins can enable and configure Azure Active Directory self-service password reset and what the self-service password reset process looks like for an end user. This feature will allow users to reset their password if they have lost or forgotten their password and are unable to get into the account. Self-service password reset can be used with Azure Active Directory free tier for cloud-only users. However, for synchronized account and password write-back, we require Azure Active Directory Premium P1 or a P2 license. Remember, this is a per-user license model, so you will need to assign a valid license to each user that needs to perform a self-service password reset. So without any further delay, let's start by learning how IT admin can enable self-service password reset for the users.
I've logged into Azure portal. Let's navigate to Azure Active Directory. Look at the option password reset. Under the properties tab, we can either select individual groups or we can enable self-service password reset feature for all the users. Once we have made the selection, click on save. Now let us navigate to authentication methods. Here, admins have option to choose number of authentication methods required for end users while resetting the password. We can choose one or two method as required. The methods selected here will be available to end users while performing self-service password reset. I'm going to choose email along with mobile phone. Click on save. Another important feature we have in the portal is notifications. Here we can configure if you'd like to notify the users or the admins if the password for the user accounts were reset. I click on yes for the admins and click on save. Last but not the least, we have an option to control password write-back feature. If we have deployed password write-back while installing Azure AD Connect, we can control whether or not this feature can be enabled. If it is set to no, the federated or the synchronized user will not be able to reset or change their password even if the password write-back feature is configured in Azure AD Connect. We can change these settings anytime. Once we have completed the setup from the admin end, let's look at it from the end user side as to how it works. On the first logon, after self-service password reset is enabled for the user will be prompted to complete self-service password reset registration, requesting for the information based on the method selected by the admin while setting up the self-service password reset. I'm going to log in as a user now in the Azure portal. So here we can see the organization requires more information to keep the account secure. We click on next. On the next screen, I am prompted either to enter a phone number or an email address. These options correspond to the options selected in the portal when the tenant admin enabled self-service password reset. I must enter one of them to receive the notification code and log in into my account. I will choose email. Once we have received the code, we can update it here and click on verify. Once we have updated the detail, click on finish. Okay, so now we have successfully completed the self-service password reset registration for the user. Now let us check what is the process for the user to reset the password. For example, let us try to log in to Azure portal and click on can't access your account. The user will be redirected to a screen prompting them to choose the type of account. The user will choose work or school account if the account was created by the IT department for use at work or school, or personal account if it is an account they have created for personal use. Once the user clicks on the account type, they will be routed to Who Are You page, wherein the user must enter the user ID and CAPTCHA. Once the user have updated all the details, the user needs to click on Next. As I have updated only email while registering for self-service password reset, I will be prompted to receive the verification code over email. Please click on Email. I have received the verification code over email. Let me go ahead and update here real quick and click on Next. I will be prompted to enter the new password. Once I have entered the new password, I'll click on Finish. Voila! I have successfully reset my password without any admin intervention.